All right, Kevin, thank you. And for your information, state health authorities are warning against a phony social media post concerning the flu. As you've heard, Oklahoma is not immune to the virus this year. 74 people have died so far from the flu this season alone, and a number of schools are also closing because of a high number of absences. Bus drivers as well, they're homesick too. Joining me now is Lawrence Burnstead with the Oklahoma State Department of Health with more on a Facebook post that's kind of like fake news going around right now. Tell us about that.
Well, in a way, somebody essentially created some information and put that it was from our agency, which it's not. Some of the facts are correct, but the key point is that when it comes to how long a child should be out of school, it just references approximately 5 days. And we want to stress that a child, if they're ill with flu symptoms, should be out until at least 24 hours after their fever has resolved, especially without using fever-reducing medication.
Okay, well, 5 days, you know, the flu lasts for a long time. My mom had it. She was out for about 2 weeks. 5 days isn't that long. Anyway, tell us, what are the actual symptoms of the flu? How does somebody know that they have it?
Right. If you're experiencing symptoms of flu, you could experience a fever, cough, sore throat, body aches, and chills. Those are the primary symptoms that a person may experience.
Extreme tiredness, fatigue. My mom had that. I felt so sorry for her. There are some misconceptions out there going around right now. My mom also got this. She got the stomach bug right after she had the flu. There's a stomach bug going around, but it's not the flu. What's the difference?
Correct. When you're talking about stomach bug, primarily the symptoms you're experiencing will be diarrhea, vomiting, stomach cramps, which is completely different from the virus that may cause influenza, which is your fever, cough, sore throat, chills. So completely different illnesses that we're referencing with those.
Yeah. Well, how do you know for certain that it's actually the flu that you have?
Right. Well, if a person is experiencing symptoms that may be due to flu, like we referenced, fever, cough, sore throat, chills, you know, you should consider that you may have flu. If you need to speak with your healthcare provider, they may perform a quick rapid test to diagnose a flu.
And what is the treatment for it?
Well, for most individuals, you know, you can just stay at home, get plenty of rest, drink fluids, and get better over several days. For some individuals, especially those that may be at high risk of severe complications, such as individuals 50 years of age and older, very young children, and persons with underlying medical conditions that affect your heart or lungs or your immune system, you should be in touch with your healthcare provider early in your symptoms because they may prescribe an antiviral medication. If taken early, that could reduce the severity and duration of your symptoms due to flu.
Within about 48 hours of first noticing the symptoms.
Correct.
A lot of people think that antibiotics can help, can it?
No. With influenza, we're talking about a virus, and antibiotics are not effective against a virus. Sometimes antibiotics might be prescribed because a person is experiencing a co-infection, which is maybe a bacterial illness at the same time as their flu-like symptoms, and so that would be treating for bacteria but not a virus.
You know, and we've heard that it's not too late to get a flu shot because even though it's only about 10% effective, it can still make it less severe. But if somebody got a flu shot early, say September, October of last year, do they need a booster shot now that we're further along in the season?
You don't need a booster shot if you've already received one earlier this season. It will protect you throughout the season. However, we do know that we're just in the middle of the season and really at our potentially peak level of transmission occurring. So we would still encourage, if you haven't gotten one yet, to go ahead and contact your healthcare provider, local health department, or other locations and still get a flu shot because we could be several weeks further into the season. Or left in the season. A few other preventive measures, though, in addition to getting your flu shot, is hand hygiene on a regular basis. Wash your hands regularly with soap and water or use alcohol-based hand gel to clean your hands. Also, if you're experiencing a cough, use cough etiquette. Cough into your sleeve or cough into a tissue, throw it away, wash your hands.
Cough etiquette, that's so important.
Exactly.
Thank you so much for being here today and clearing that up for us. Don't spread that Facebook post as well as your germ.